Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm very pleased to be here, and I'm very pleased to see we have quite an audience for the second day of School of Development. I'll try to present a few points about Romania's profile as an official development assistance donor from our perspectives, from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs view. So, following the accession to the European Union in 2007, Romania committed itself to promoting a national policy on development cooperation, with the aim to eradicate global poverty in the broader context of achieving the Millennium Development Goals. So far, our efforts in organizing an ODA national program have included a wide consultation process on the development cooperation policy, both with the civil society and other domestic partners, as well as the partner states in drafting the national policies and their implementation. We will continue to include all potential stakeholders in this process in order to achieve a synergy that will be beneficial for both the partner countries and Romania. From the very beginning of drafting the ODA programming documents in 2006-2007, the need to integrate these efforts in a regional context was obvious to us. In this respect, Romania supports bilateral, regional, and thematic initiatives in relation with the partner countries from the eastern and southern neighborhood, and we look to create opportunities for synergies with various regional processes and initiatives in our neighborhood, such as the EU strategy for the Danube region, the Black Sea Synergy, the Eastern Partnership. Strengthening regional cooperation was, as a matter of fact, always a key priority for our foreign policy. Therefore, it is natural that our ODA efforts are directed primarily towards our immediate neighborhood. At the same time, it holds true also that it is from this region that we get most requests for assistance, and especially in this respect, most requests for assistance come from the Republic of Moldova. Regarding other parts of the world, in Middle East and North Africa, we support countries facing political instability. We turn to these countries at their request for assistance, and we believe we can bring a significant contribution in the area of transition processes due to our own experience and know-how, a know-how that we have achieved over the last 25 years in our own transition from communism. And I mean, when I refer to transition, both in governance and socio-economic. Generally, we want to emphasize solidarity with developing countries through a responsible foreign policy focused on results, especially by sharing expertise and lessons learned in the transition that I just referred to, our transition to democracy over the last quarter of a century. The main topics we cooperate in this area are institution building, electoral assistance, administration reform, and security. And because I mentioned security, I'd like to highlight that this is a key area of interest for us. Security and conflict prevention, and increasing the contribution of the internationally recognized Romanian expertise in the field. For several years now, the Romanian Ministry of Foreign Affairs has been organizing numerous trainings in this area, and Romanian personnel is participating in EU and United Nations missions in various parts of the world affected by conflicts. One of the most successful programs in this area is the annual course on post-conflict reconstruction and stabilization that we have organized over the last 7 years. This project is part of our efforts to develop and consolidate the national mechanisms and procedures for training civilian experts and managing the necessary resources for participation in stabilization and reconstruction operations. And I have to say that we are very happy with the positive feedback we received year after year from the participants. And one of my co-panelists is also helping us. Juana is delivering one of an important course in this training program, and she had also this experience with our participants. And beside this very positive feedback we received every year, recently we have also financed an evaluation of the training, and the report came out with very positive findings. You can find the report for those interested on our website, www.aod.ro. I also must underline that at EU level, Romania is very well represented in the CSDP civilian missions. For example, we are on fifth place among contributors regarding seconded personnel with 53 experts, same number as Italy. And on first position regarding contractual personnel with 72 experts. The statistics I'm quoting is from 30th of April 2015, so it's up to date. Since 2007, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs has also funded a number of projects to increase the capacity of public institutions in various fields, such as public policy, combating discrimination and corruption, as well as education. In the area of anti-discrimination, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs has supported the consolidation of the institutional capacity and legal framework on good governance, migration, and asylum system in the Republic of Moldova, and contributed to increasing the capacity of national institutions to organize the census of population and houses in the Republic of Moldova, to give just an example. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs has also funded projects for confidence building between Chișinău and Tiraspol, and I'm referring, of course, to the frozen conflict in Transnistria, in order to enhance the dialogue between the two parts as a prerequisite for the extension of the political stabilization process. In the field of diplomacy and international relations, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs has organized training programs for civil servants and diplomats from Republic of Moldova, but also from partner countries, mainly in the Middle East and North Africa region. In North Africa, we do also support electoral assistance programs and administrative reform or integrity. Many of these projects will be presented in the project fair tomorrow, I understand, with the help of fund, and I like to express my thanks for this help. And generally, it is my duty to highlight the excellent cooperation we have had with the fund over the last 7-8 years, mainly with our common project regarding the NGO forum at the Black Sea, which is an important part of the Black Sea synergy, and especially in this period, an important area of soft power, let's say, that we can engage in the Black Sea region. So again, many thanks, and I'm sure the project fair tomorrow will be very interesting. As a final remark, I just want to underline that our philosophy as a donor is sharing the lesson learned. We do have an experience, we did learn some important lessons, we think, and we are ready and willing to contribute in this important endeavor alongside the partner states. That being said, I think I will stop here, and if there will be any comments and questions, I'll be happy to reply. Thank you so much.